All right, good morning. My name is Anders Hallden and you are welcome to my house. I work as the general manager at Waterfront here in the city and been here now for 6 years. Today we're gonna cook one of my specialities, one of my sweet meatballs that we always cook at home. And to assist me today, I have my son Odin, named after the Scandinavian god Odin, the god of wisdom. And to my left, I have my daughter Freya, which is named after the god of love. So, to the actual cooking.
This is in partnership with Waterfront Cebu City Hotel and Casino.
We have minced beef, we have salt, we have Dijon mustard, nutmeg, onions, egg, breadcrumbs and cream. That's for the meatballs. If you've been on IKEA, you are all familiar with this already. Then for the sauce, we do one beef stock, we have soya sauce, we have flour, we have butter and a secret ingredient, lingonsylt, directly from Sweden. Then of course some cream, it's multi-purpose. To make the meatballs is a very, very simple procedure that everybody can make at home and it goes very, very quick. The only thing you need is two assistants and a master chef. Onion, I chopped them already. It's a white onion, they go all in. Then I have two eggs straight in the bag, followed by breadcrumbs so we can suck up the fat inside the minced beef itself. I would think that's enough. As you see, I don't use measurements too much, but it's all up to one in each other to do how you much you want of each. Pepper. Then we have salt. Then we have mustard, which I'm gonna need a spoon, Odin. Assistant, spoon. In the meantime, when we wait on the assistant, we use the nutmeg. Spoon, please. Thank you. Nice big chunk there. We like mustard. So, and then a dash of cream. You like cream. Cream is good for the body. Cream and butter. Everything tastes better. All right, now we have the mixture. Now, hands dirty. Just go in. Mix it carefully all the way. We want to make sure that all the mince are incorporated in the mixture. We must make sure that they are well rolled so that they keep together later during the frying. So, bowl number one. So kids, follow this bowl. Make sure you roll properly and nice and round shapes. Thank you very much, assistants. So, as you saw from the beginning, I use butter and I use flour. That's my rule. That's what makes the sauce thick. Then I poured in my beef stock, which is literally just bones that have been boiling in vegetables and so forth for a very long time to get all this flavor out. And then you see it's already adding up quite thickly. And I had the soya sauce inside for a little bit of saltiness and the color. Now I added some milk because otherwise I think it's gonna be too rich for most people here. I like a lot of cream and a lot of butter, but here not so popular in my house. And then we're gonna see if we are ready to start frying some meatballs. What do we need? Butter, of course. Rolled balls by my lovely assistants, Odin and Freya, my kids, very good. I will put them in this one. And then we're gonna finish them with braising them, it's called. So, here we go. Here is svenska köttbullar med potatismos I gräddsås och lingonsylt. Swedish meatballs in a creamy sauce, mashed potatoes and lingonberry jam made by Freya, Odin and myself, Anders. Bon appétit, and if you by any chance wouldn't want to make it at your home, you can always come to Waterfront and I make it for you.